Hey everyone, ladies and gentlemen, this is Stas Ferenc, and we are here once more for GWA Saturday Night Wrestling. As always, hold on a sec.
Oh, here's.
No, I'm just doing some announcing, that's all. Joining me, as always, is my broadcast partner, Carter. And tonight is a bit of a sad night. For those who know and for those who don't know, last night at age, what was it, 79? Yeah, it was 79.
Yes.
And Antonio Inoki, one of the all-time greats in Japanese wrestling and the legend in his own right, passed away. Among his accomplishments, he was the founder of New Japan Pro Wrestling. And was truly, truly ahead of his time. Not without his controversies, but still, the man was honored and was respected. And so, for tonight, in our main event, no less, we will have a tribute match to honor Antonio Inoki and his accomplishments. So look forward to that later tonight. Also on the card, after a couple of back and forth and some glaring, and some backstage glaring, Duke Fed and Larson are finally going to go head-to-head, one-on-one. To get that weight off their chests, and maybe both of them can move on. We also have a proper debut for a man who showed up last week for what he thought was just going to be a one-off match. But he ended up surprising everyone when he went damn near 30 minutes. 30 minutes. Against the demon of the GWA, Demon Black.
What a performance it was, although he was not ultimately victorious. That made his struggle all the more poignant, I think.
That is true. And so, ladies and gentlemen, we open up our tonight's show with a proper debut of the man who surprised us all. Jerry Armstrong, and he, for his first proper match in the GBA, will be going one-on-one with one of our regulars here, the Nacho Man, Pedro Fernandez.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
All right. The proper debut of Jerry Armstrong. He's got a chance to really show us what he can do.
He sure has had a trial by fire.
Playing a little mind games with Armstrong.
Be right back.
Oh! Sorry about that.
Oh, there, and I thought it was on my end. I was about to restart.
Yeah, I completely forgot about that. Sorry.
Thank you. Oh, Armstrong is about to go outside the hard way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's a bow and arrow. Sizing each other up right now.
Oh. Both men spent from that impact.
Shade of blows here. Back and forth they go. Oh! Oh! I could not have been good for Nacho's knees.
I can't imagine.
Again with the mind games.
But he can back it up with a killer hold like that.
Mm-hmm. Stomp it pose. Oh! Big forearms. Oh, man. Armstrong seemed to have just blasted Nacho Man with his chair.
Oh.
All those mock kicks.
Solid arm drag sets Fernandez up in the corner.
Drag him back to the center, down onto the W. Now starts raking the head with the elbow. Oh! He's back up on his feet after that chop.
He's just about sick of Nacho Man's
screen neckbreaker. Off the ropes, drops the elbow. Trying to drop an elbow of his own. Another swinging neckbreaker. Drags Nacho back to the center and drops him with the elbow. Picks him up. Hits him with the 1-2.
Not going to give in to that.
Big arm drag. Ooh. Oh, nice backdrop. Back and forth they go again. Stomps the back. Circle each other. Big arm drag. Ooh! DDT! Oh wow! The arm turns back up on his feet first though.
A cutter out of nowhere.
This is that same resiliency he saw that he showed in his fighting in his match with Black last week. Well, they're trying to catch their breath here.
And being an Iron Man is a time-honored style.
Indeed.
The trick is keeping it up over long enough to call it a career.
Oh!
Oh, simple but effective.
Oh!
Thank you. Very clever. Caught him with the chop while he went for the chair.
Oh! 20 minutes. Coming up to the 21-minute mark.
Nails him with that DD, running DDT. Oh, but he's
in the ropes.
Cuts on the ropes. So that Northern Light suplex does not.
Boom! Smoke drop.
Oh,
Armstrong is fired up. And again, Armstrong nails him with a chair.
I think we might have to check the VOD on that one.
So is that again, but it doesn't follow. This time he's just supposed to try to catch his breath. Pulls him to the corner. Pulls him to the center and picks him up. Oh.
Fells Armstrong like a tree, then poses next to him on the mat. Oh,
counter for a counter. Armstrong's back up first, picks up. Oh, this might do it. That's it. Oh.
Once again, Armstrong pushes an established star to their limits.
Yeah.
But does not ultimately come out successful. And we haven't seen the last of him, but it'll be interesting to see where he settles, because he technically debuted at a kind of a high spot on the card, going up against former champion Demon Black.
Yeah.
But
when you think about it, Armstrong was probably just going to be perhaps the latest victim in Black's rampage to get back up to the top. And he just went and surprised everyone when he damn near went the distance. He almost ran out the clock, if you will.
That he did. That he almost did.
All right. Coming up next, two superstars are going to get some heat out of their systems and hopefully move on from there. We've been told that Black Raven is not allowed nowhere near ringside, so these two men can just get it off their chests and get it over with. Even though just got two up on Larson, they weren't actual matches, so we're taking a lot of back and forth that we have heard has been happening backstage. Ortega is basically saying, all right, you two, you are fighting in the ring, get out of your system, and then move on. And so... Luke Fed and Larson are one-on-one.
Duke Fed one of the shining stars of GWA and
rising star at that.
And the so-called lunatic Larson has some sort of.
From what I've been able to glean, it's a past rivalry from their days in the indie circuit. Larson hadn't exactly let it go, hence his previous attacks. On Fed.
Ooh, going right for the stomach claw. Misses the roundhouse.
Oh!
Misses the drop kick. Pulls guard, rolls him up. He gets him out of the corner, which is. Ooh, almost gets dumped out of the ring entirely.
Ooh!
Stomach claw again.
Whoa! Round and round he goes. Where he flies, only Larson knows.
MMA style giant swing. A la Kazushi Sakuraba.
Ooh, big right to the eye. Oh, blocks the punch. Off the ropes goes Duke, but he bodies Larson to the ground.
It's almost like it's clear these men have a very deep rivalry, because it's almost like they're reading each other's minds at times.
Indeed. Oh! Oh, into an arm bar.
Oh,
Larson responds with a headbutt. Nice shoulder tackle. Moves Salt into a cover. One.
Nope, not nearly enough for Larson.
Oh! Let's just snag that from catering before the match.
Yeah, that's a hell of a fork.
Oh, cover one. Nope. Big DDT.
Oh. The blood loss seems to be getting to Duke Fed.
Oh!
Oh, he escapes it back into the ring before Larson can line up a solid weapon shot.
Oh!
Boom. The machine gun chops. Oh, Larson is not having any of that.
Nope. Oh, back with the headbutts. Thankfully, Duke was at the ropes.
Yeah.
He pulls him over into a Scorpion Death Drop.
Not enough for Larson.
I guess I'm in an ankle lock.
I could do some serious damage. Oh, Larson nails it.
Oh! Larson showing off his technical side of his own. Slams it with that Osagori Bomber. Oh, again with the catering fork. Oh, that is deep. Oh, off the ropes. Pulls him over, stomps to the knee. Oh, cover one, two. Oh, and that's it. Larson gets the win.
After a hard-fought match, Larson finally crushes Duke Fett into a cube.
Seems to be a smile on Larson's face as he walks off, somewhat satisfied with himself, it seems. All right, coming up next. We have the Geisha taking on Konami.
This should be interesting.
Yeah, it should. Now representing another promotion as a part of the GWA, Big League Japan, one of the top all female promotions in Japan, is the Geisha now representing. And we have in the ring Big League Japan referee Mizuki to call the match.
Oh, I remember back when Big League
Japan. Here we go! Wow! Oh, right into the submission. Nice recovery by the geisha. Oh, wow. Back and forth they go. So the couple, ladies and gentlemen, we do know that Demon Black will be in action later on. Actually, he'll be on next. And but later on, World Heavyweight Champion Ortega will be going one-on-one against Ronin. And of course, our main event, our tribute match to the late great Antonio Inoki. You don't want to miss that.
Has not yet hit with that miss. That could be a costly tactical error.
Of the ropes! Oh, baseball slide right into Geisha's face.
Doesn't get the job done this time.
It wasn't perfect enough.
Oh,
slams into the corner, goes Konami. But she fights her way out.
Oh. What the?
What is the demon doing out here? Oh my god. What is the demon doing out here? Oh! Thank you.
This took a strange turn.
Jesus!
Not a team up I was anticipating.
I mean, even Konami seems shocked. She's trying to flow with it, but what the hell is the demon doing out here?
Not quite.
Tim!
Not this time.
Oh!
And I go to sleep. Will.
Oh.
Not seal the deal.
Oh! Almost got its ring out.
Oh.
Oh. Cover one, two. Oh.
And just like that, she finally puts Konami away.
I still want to know what the deal was, and ladies and gentlemen, I just got word that following that attack from by Damon Black, he just left. There, he's nowhere to be found. So we do not know who's going to be in the match now. Local talent Gold Lightning is making his way down to the ring. But we don't know who his opponent's going to be. Pick coming out. Oh! Is the number one contender for the TV title and the Canadian Crusher himself, Chase Ford.
Interesting.
Well, someone needed to take Black's place since he just pretty much left after interfering with the Geisha and Konami match, which ultimately cost Konami the match. And I guess Chase said, you know what, I'll go out. Let me show everyone why I'm number one contender. Off the ropes! Big sling blade.
Ooh. Punches him right upside the head. But it's going to take a little more than that to stop Chase Ford. Oh, he gets out of the corner before Chase Ford can do something really ugly.
They circle each other.
Tremendous choke slam puts Gold Lightning all over the corner.
Lightning throws him off. Off the ropes! Oh! Blocks that. Who the hell is this guy?
Huh.
This is coming out of the wood. They're just coming out of the woodwork now. Oh, he's going after Chase! Oh! Oh!
This is a chop.
Now, whoever he is, he didn't seem to be able to be much help, but Jason did not seem happy by the interference, and Moineau looks rather annoyed as well. Him down with a big shoulder tackle. Cover, one, two!
Not yet.
Oh, Oh, trips him, rolls him over, picks him up. Trying to choke him out.
Catches the larger man in a big spine buster.
Two! Trips him, rolls him over, picks him up.
Flips Chase Ford over like a lawn dart.
Oh! Idiot backbreaker! Canadian clutch. Again, Lightning throws himself, gets off. Swinging that breaker. Suplex City cover! One! Two!
No!
Ooh, Chase looking a little winded there.
Yeah, he's exhausted. Again.
Oh, big F5. Goes into the corner. And another F5. Oh, he just flexed on Chase there. Oh, he made a pay! Good God! Rolls him up. Oh, no. Was that like the fourth F5?
Something like that.
Into the Canadian clutch. And that's it. Lightning taps.
They put up a good effort, but in the end, he was pretty badly stomped by Chase Ford.
Question is, though, who was that mystery guy that tried to help out Lightning? That's coming up next. La Grenouille steps up to the plate. Taking on Zero Razor of Pro Super Japan. And so we are bringing out Kiyoshi Kobata to referee the match. Here he comes, the self-proclaimed scourge of the GWA, Zero Razor, makes his way to the ring. Make it 2-0 for the French Canadians tonight. Oh! As he gets dumped, as he gets shit-canned to the outside by Zero.
Oh. The extra time to set up that light bulb shot was not enough.
Seem to be mocking Zero right there with that foot on his chest. Oh!
Where did that come from?
I think he borrowed that from Larson. Oh, roll up! There's the scythe again. Oh, big arm drag. Zero off the earth. Oh, nope.
Shooting star press.
Damn. Oh, this is that wheel kick. Back and forth they go. Zero wins that exchange, gets back to his feet, pulls him from the corner, and starts lobbing punches right into Nakagami's face. Oh, spins him around. Oh, gets him to a choke.
Well, let's do it.
Simple but effective.
Oh, dragon screw reversal.
Oh! Off the ropes! Oh! Crossbody cover! Cross one! Body. Two! Oh. Off the ropes again! Oh! Big Superman punch! Nails it with those kicks.
Well, he gave up to the giant swing, not this time.
Yeah. Number one, two. Lay it. Lays it with that combo. Shoulder tackle from the top rope. Off the rope. Drops the elbow.
Double arm DDT.
That guy stopped short, too. Second time. Cover. One. Two. Uh-oh. Oh, geez. Wait. Nice.
Wow, what a reversal.
Back and forth they go again.
That might cost Gron Lee the match.
Oh, Gron Lee's going, trying again. And again, zero counters. The ropes go zero. Oh, pop up into a cutter. Frog splash. Throws him up. One.
Well, let's do it.
Two. No. Zero throws him off. Thank you. Jesus Christ!
Oh, just that table swing.
Oh, Jesus.
Well, he gave up.
No!
Not this time.
Minutes have passed. Zero off the ropes. Big Superman punch.
You could hear the impact on that one. Let's do it.
That's it.
After a valiant effort, Zero Razor is not able to defeat La Grande Wii.
Nope. Next up, we've got another debut tonight. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Her name is Arale, and she is the daughter of GWA veteran Ravenzo. And she is known as the Voodoo Queen.
Well, let's see what kind of voodoo she can do here.
Indeed.
Neither woman is wasting any time.
Oh!
Oh! Oh, Liberty's got your LA up and drops her.
They go.
Yes. Yes. Your rally seems to be stronger than Lady Liberty. And can clearly just lift her off the ground like a sack of potatoes. Oh dear. Yeah, Lady Liberty's gonna have to work hard to find an inn here.
Oh! Oh, don't!
Good positioning by your rally there. Good show of ring savvy. What'd you expect from a multi-generation wrestler?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Lady Liberty looking for the upper hand, but does not overplay her advantage.
Yeah, Liberty's a veteran here. She's also a veteran here with GBA, so they're all these guys so got a workaround for her in this.
Yep, you won't catch Liberty making an easy mistake like
ooh,
missing a top rope move.
Oh! Tries to wear it down, wears her down with a jump, choke there. Oh, goes her back, rolls her over, picks her up. Oh!
Oh!
Bulldog.
Nails her with that sidekick. Not quite.
Yeah. Oh! Cover. One. Two! Oh!
And she got her.
What a debut for Arale.
Only 12 and a half minutes.
Sax is doing some adjustments here. There we go. Coming up next, we've got Kaiba Romi taking on Black Raven.
Or can't miss women's action here on GWA.
Oh, definitely. Referee John Coleman going to be stepping in for these next group of matches.
Slaps the mist right out of her mouth.
Right? Damn.
What a start to this match. Romy certainly came to fight, and
oh,
Raven is no slouch either.
And there's Raven's, I think they're dating now. Larson interfering. That's early. Really?
Burning hammer.
Chair. Courtesy of Larson. Oh, guy with the... Oh! Damn, how much Mrs. Raven have?
Enough.
Apparently.
Oh. Wheelbarrow bomb.
into a Boston Crab. That was painful.
Really going for that arm bar.
Go ground and pound. Down she goes. Ooh, sorry about that. Oh, and again, again with the double missed.
Ooh.
The guy even makes her pay with those back-to-back slaps. Might be regretting those.
Oh, flipped onto the chair.
Cover one, two. Oh, almost.
That just about had her. Spinning leg sweep.
Oh, nice bridge cover. One, two.
Not quite this time. Big arm drag for.
Oh,
missed again. Right on her head.
Radio DDT, will this do it? I know, she picks her up. Oh, there's the morning hammer!
That could do it.
Cover. One, two. Kaiba catches. Raven off guard.
Just save for a few touch and go moments there. Pretty much steamrolled her. Fell her close.
Indeed. Well, match overall. Kaiba just really starting to pick things up.
Yeah, she's been showing us a lot since she came on board.
All right, everyone. Coming up next, everyone's favorite aristocrat that you just love to boo, the gentleman, Harry Johnson. He's going one-on-one next against the most badass grandpa in the GWA, Nuclear Gandhi himself, Ravana. Ladies and gentlemen, we are just two matches away from our main event and our Antonio Aquino tribute match.
It's a can't miss.
Indeed. Wow, it's fired up. Fight.
Or, oh. Both men shoot on each other and both men miss.
Nuclear Gandhi, yep.
Oh, well,
to break the kayfabe, Sarah, it's a reference to a meme from Civilization where Gandhi, like, for whatever reason, from game to game, is really, really nuke-happy.
Well, that might be the most successful use of a foreign object we've ever seen.
Tonight, anyways.
Maybe ever. He landed two solid shots on Johnson before dropping it.
No! No, wait! Ravana throws him off quickly. Throws him off again! How you doing, Sarah? Glad to have you. Glad to have you here with us. Actually, Sarah, that was proven to be false. It just,
what's that?
The reason behind Gandhi being Cappy.
Oh, what, the overrun error?
Yeah, everybody thought it was a result of an overrun error. It's more or less just a happy coincidence with, because it can't actually go below zero. So it's just a happy coincidence due to the fact that the democracy suit, which Gandhi almost always is guaranteed to take, the AI, just happens to be around the same time where nukes are unlocked. So it's just a happy coincidence that kind of turned into a meme that the fan base and Firaxis himself just rolled with.
Ooh.
Oh!
Oh, Ravana's not having it. Oh! Down goes Johnson. Uh-oh.
Woo.
Almost had him.
Yep.
No.
No, this is Fire Pro Wrestling World Decoy. What is up? This is the eighth match of the show out of 10. And we have the gentleman, Harry Johnson, the redhead here in the black and gold, taking on Ravana, known as the most badass grandpa in the GWA. Oh, roll up, cover, 1, 2. But how are you doing, Decoy? Welcome to the stream. Glad to have you here. 1, 2. Slide, cover, 1, 2. Oh, what a pile driver.
Still not enough. That got him.
Woo! And Johnson just cannot catch a break at all.
It certainly looks that way, but he's had some stiff opponents.
The leprechaun throwing Gandhi around is named Harry Johnson, and Gandhi is called Ravana. All right, coming up next, GWA World Heavyweight Champion Ortega is in action, and he'll be going up again. And he'll be going 1-on-1 against the Samurai Ronin. And then, ladies and gentlemen, after this, we will have our main event, the Antonio Inoki tribute match, in honor of the late great Antonio Inoki, who passed away last night. He is one of the greatest Japanese professional wrestlers in the history of professional wrestling, and probably one of his biggest accomplishments is that he is the founder of New Japan Pro Wrestling. One of the biggest Japanese pro wrestling promotions in all of
Right. But in the meantime, here comes the boss.
He's going to be facing Lorenzo in 3 weeks' time at Grand Tour, putting that title on the line.
Oh, Ortega getting things off to a impactful start, and Ronan following suit.
Let's see how Lauren does against the champ, though. A solid performance here. Could put him in the title hunt later down the line.
Oh, absolutely.
Simple but effective, but he was in the ropes. Oh! Oh! Ortega quickly throws him off the boat.
Doesn't get the chance to run off the ropes. Who's going to win this exchange? Ortega chops him halfway across the ring.
And Ronan tosses him across the other half. Oh, big arm drag. Smart move, working on those legs, weakening the bigger man's foundation there.
Definitely a solid tactic.
Indeed. Oh, drops it down. Pulls him over. Oh! Off the ropes! Nope. Cover! 1, 2!
Oh, Ortega is not lying around and set the pace.
That is the sign of the two cramp there. Ortega's trying to keep it. Oh, wait.
Oh, this could be trouble for Ortega.
Excuse me. Fuck. to the crowd. The ropes, drops the ring.
Oh, down goes Ortega right on his face. Oh, he comes back with another leg drop. Up there in the ropes.
Oh, rolls him into that leg lock. And again, in the ropes.
Oh, this could be trouble.
Oh, goes in with that Russian combo. Oh, it's the flip kick. That left Ortega dazed and rolls him into that leg lock again.
What a display, but it's still not enough.
Yeah. But he's slowly wearing down Ortega. There's only so much the limbs can take. Cover, one, two. Oh, almost got him. Goes again for the buzzsaw kick. Two.
Oh. And three lariat. Will that be enough to stop Ronan? Maybe not.
No ropes, though.
And again.
Oh! Oh, it's that leg lock. Oh, there's that combo again. Oh! Ortega saw it coming this time. Uh-oh. Whoa!
it's impossible to tell who's going to give up first.
I know, right? Oh! Big spear!
Folded him in half with that one.
Drops the knee. Or drops the leg.
And another buzzsaw kick.
Connor Willis, do it! One, two! And that's it! Corey got it!
Wow. Hard-earned victory over the reigning champion of the company. That's definitely going to earn Ronan a place at the table later.
Oh, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next... Your main events. Our tribute to the late great Antonio Inoki. Get ready, this will be a pretty awesome match. Inoki Bombaye. Who do I have as Inoki's opponent for this tribute match? Hey, Flame Wolf, you are just in time. Our main event, the last match of the night, tribute match to the late, great Antonio Inoki, who passed away last night. And here comes Inoki now. The question is, though, who is his opponent going to be? Hulk Hogan!
From a very specific time and place. But not the one you're used to seeing. Ooh. Thank you.
Sarah, that was early 80s. Like, Hogan wrestled for New Japan in like 83, 84. And that was his theme song back then. My only regret is I fucked up setting up his custom entrance that I didn't set to trigger on all the arenas.
Big boot.
Sorry about that. The music is kind of loud. Oh, counter.
A swastika hold. Another one of his innovative moves.
He's just wearing him down with that. The count is actually can actually differ depending on where you are. In Japan, they do a 20 count, which is what Fire Pro uses. Although you can also set it to a 10 count, but in American wrestling, they have it as a 10 count. They do a 10 count rather than a 20.
Jumping pop forever.
Yeah. When Hogan was in Japan, he wrestled in a very, very different style than what we're used to. He actually has a very, like, technical... He actually trained to wrestle a very technical moveset. Style, but... But when he was in the States, you know, in WWE and whatnot, he was just made to wrestle like a big power guy. He didn't get the chance to like show what he can do. But I saw a video of one of Hogan's Japan matches in Japan, where he like throws out a freaking enziguri. Like an enziguri or a shining wizard, like stuff like that. Like, oh my god. And this wrestled a very technical style, you know, like holds, takedowns, and stuff like that.
Yeah, he was a totally different specimen.
Oh!
The feigning sleeper.
Damn! Cover one, two! And rather than the leg drop, in Japan, he used the axe bomber, which is a bent arm clothesline. So instead of going like that, he had his arm was bent like that. So he goes like that rather than like that. If you understand what I'm trying to say.
Oh, call with the Enziguri! Which Antonio Inoki is the innovator of.
Yep. Slide facing the ropes. Oh, Hogan taps.
He got him.
What a way to end the show. And ladies and gentlemen, that is it. That is the end. And I want to thank you all for coming to watch and to pay your respects to Inoki. May he rest in peace and God bless him and all that he did for us in wrestling. On behalf of Carter, I want, again, thank you all for coming. Don't forget to join us next week for more great wrestling action. And until then, y'all have a good night. And this is Stas Verence, signing off.